Can we simply store energy with air? Apparently so. It's not that simple, but we can. This technology is called compressed air energy storage, or CAES for short. In a nutshell, compressed air energy storage uses electricity to compress and store air into underground reservoirs or purpose-built tanks, which can later be used to generate electricity when needed. This video will explain how compressed air energy storage works, the different types, and its pros and cons. Now let's see how it actually works. When electricity is available, so normally when there is a surplus and prices are low, we can use that electricity to drive an electric motor. The motor then drives a series of turbines which compress the air into either a large underground cavern or a purpose-built tank. For the sake of simplicity, I'll be explaining the systems that use caverns, but the process is essentially the same. When it's time to discharge, because the grid needs electricity, a valve lets the compressed air flow towards a series of turbines connected to a generator. As the air expands, it cools down, so you want to heat it up to increase the electricity that can be produced. How the air is heated up depends on the system. We have two main types of compressed air energy storage, adiabatic and adiabatic. In adiabatic plants, the heat from the compression stage is lost and not captured. So when the air is later expanded to generate electricity, it is mixed and heated up with gas, or natural gas, as some like to call it. Adiabatic is an improvement to the adiabatic system. Since gases heat up when compressed and cool down when expanded, adiabatic systems capture the heat at the compression stage and store it in a thermal energy store, which can contain gravel, which is then reused to heat up the air when expanded. Due to the utilization of the heat within the system and not needing to add natural gas, adiabatic CAES can achieve 70% round-trip efficiency, whilst adiabatic achieves around 45% efficiency. Another important step of the process is keeping the cavern at a constant pressure. The way plants do that is by using water. When the compressed air flows into the cavern, water is pumped out and stored in a reservoir. When the compressed air goes back out, in order to maintain the pressure, water is pumped in to replace the gaps the air left. Why do we use salt caverns? Salt caverns can sustain the high pressures of the air, have lower leakage, and good thermal insulation. Interestingly, depleted natural gas fields could potentially be used as well. I didn't mention it as a third main system alongside adiabatic and adiabatic, but there is another, way less developed solution, isothermal compressed energy storage. Here, the aim is to compress and expand the gas at a constant temperature through parallel injection of liquids. So how developed is compressed air energy storage as a whole? There are only two large and operational CAES plants, one built in Germany in 1978 and the other in the US in 1991. Together, their power capacity is 400 megawatts. However, they both use adiabatic systems, which is the one with the natural gas. There are some small adiabatic projects that are operational and many other projects looking to being built, but CAES does, or at least used to have, a history of delays and cancellations of projects. However, many exciting startups are starting to pop up. So what applications will compressed energy storage have then? Well, due to its lower energy costs than other batteries, it is more suitable for longer durations. Currently, they cover 8 hours of storage, but could go up to 24 hours of discharge. And as batteries become cheaper, CAES will see itself cover longer durations rather than shorter ones. Compressed air energy storage is normally only economical at large scale and longer discharge durations, which is why it's quite similar to pumped hydro storage. Finally, what are the cons of CAES? Firstly, it's quite location dependent, as it requires good geological formations such as salt caverns. However, if the air is stored above ground in tanks, then this is not an issue. The former might be cheaper, but is constrained to a few locations, whilst the latter is more expensive, but can be modularized and can be placed anywhere. Due to the size of the projects, which is due to the CAES having a low energy density, it can be a challenge to get financing. Another final con is that adiabatic CAES isn't that great, to be honest, because of its low efficiency and, more importantly, its emissions from the natural gas used. To conclude on what CAES might look like in the near future, most of the innovations are focused on cost reductions and more efficient heat storing. CAES could most likely dominate a certain energy storage application, being the medium to long duration storage. As our energy becomes more variable and intermittent through renewables, being able to store energy for longer durations is key for grid stability and energy security. Having longer duration storage also decreases how much renewable capacity we would need, which can reduce overall system costs.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video and want to learn more about climate change, don't forget to subscribe.